This is Dharma Drops with your host, Rebecca Warfield. This podcast is a little bit about yoga, a little bit about life, and a little bit about whatever. And just as a warning, this podcast is unscripted, so that means I might regret a few things that I say. But hey, maybe I'll say some pretty awesome stuff too. Remember, these are musings, not truths. Buckle up, giddy up, because here we go. Oh, hello. Welcome to the second Dharma Mini Drops episode. I am your host, Rebecca Warfield, and I'm really excited to be here with you today for this little shorty of an episode that's designed to hold you over until the longer, regular Dharma Drops episodes come out. So just as a reminder, if this is maybe the first time you're tuning in to the mini episodes, this is just a brief little drop of Dharma for you on Wednesdays, and then the regular podcast episodes will come out every other Friday as usual. So right now, the Dharma Mini Drops episodes are based upon the weekly card readings that come out on the blogs. And for now, we'll stick with that. But really, who knows? These mini drops could turn into anything that we want. I'm just really into card readings right now, but I do have some ideas for some other really cool stuff to do for the mini drops. But in any case, if I keep talking, this isn't going to be a mini drop. It's going to be a forever drop. So let's go ahead and get started into this week's card reading, which if you saw on the blog, the card that I pulled is the Listen Quietly card from the Inquire Within card deck. So let's get into this. It's probably not going to come as a surprise, especially for those of you who listen to the podcast on the reg, that my skill set emphasizes talking over listening. In fact, sometimes I can be a pretty shitty listener and a little rude. In fact, I was just talking on the episode with Anna Hendricks that came out on Friday, February 14th. Happy belated Valentine's Day. That I have a tendency, so I've been told, to just freaking walk away from conversations when I'm not enjoying them anymore. So if I've done that to you, I'm really sorry. I don't even know that I'm doing it. I guess in my brain, I'm just done. So I'm sorry. It's not personal. I don't even know that I'm doing it. But now that I'm aware, I've been trying to stop that. So in any case, I'm not really much of a chit chatter. I'm not really down with like the how's the weather mumbo jumbo stuff. But given the right situation, I can run my mouth. And just a little side note, I can talk so much that last year, Angela and I went to lunch and we talked so long, we stayed for dinner. And then I got back to my car after lunch and dinner and I had a parking ticket, but she didn't. I don't know how it happened, but in any case, I digress. I'm a native Marylander living in the South, which has been truly a cultural experience, to say the least. And many folks that I talk with can attest that I, quote, interrupt on the reg. And I just want to clarify that those interruptions are actually called cooperative overlappings. It's something where, like, it seems like you're interrupting, but it's actually a way of connecting with the conversation. It's not a true interruption. So if I've interrupted you, just know I'm actually cooperatively overlapping you. But what this, quote, interruption or cooperative overlapping is, it's actually just a battle between hearing and talking. And that's the operative word today for this reading, a battle. If you look on the blog or in the show notes for this episode, the card is shown with a conch shell. At first glance, that's pretty easy to figure out. It's the concept that if you quietly listen into the conch shell and just, I can't say conch shell without feeling weird about it. I'm just saying, but it just sounds terrible. But if you quietly listen inside of it, you can hear the vastness of the ocean. If you want to put a dirty ass conch shell up to your ear, look, I don't trust the ocean. I respect the ocean. I think we should take the plastic out of the ocean. We should save the ocean. But that does not mean I have to trust the weird shit that comes out of the ocean. So historically, the conch shell was blown to signal the commencement of battle. As such, the conch shell is a symbolic representation of war. So sure, yes, to listen quietly, you must engage in battle. Okay, but let's talk about what that battle actually means. So I have a little story here to share with you. One time in my pre-yoga life, because I have a pre-yoga life and then I have my after-yoga life. In my pre-yoga life, I was a much different person. In fact, you probably wouldn't have liked me. In fact, I didn't like me in my pre-yoga life. Thank God we have yoga. The one time in my pre-yoga life, I was at a taco stand and I cooperatively overlapped, not interrupted, I cooperatively overlapped an acquaintance one too many times. He was Southern. He didn't like it. He lost his shit. It turned into this huge argument. And again, this was my pre-yoga life, so I probably fed into that argument. I'm sure I did. So Daniel, if you're out there, I'm sorry. But I felt really misunderstood. He thought I was being disrespectful and all I was trying to do was connect. But in any case, it turned into a fight. But that's not the kind of war this card is talking about. Instead, I see this card as an invitation to witness the inner war, the battle we engage in every day between body, mind, and spirit, these scuffles that we regularly entertain between our thoughts versus reality. And you might be thinking like, inner war, what are you talking about? But just as a little side note, in fact, the Bhagavad Gita takes place on a battlefield. It's the story where Arjuna has to go into battle and he has to fight his friends, his family members, his teachers, because if they win the battle, they're going to take over the kingdom, but they're going to do bad things as leaders of the kingdom. And so very long story short, in the Bhagavad Gita, it takes place on the battlefield because it's a representation of the war within, that our life is a constant battle between the shit that runs through our minds, between the disconnects we have in our mind, body, and spirit, between the things that we want to do versus what we know we should do, versus the things that we know we should do but we don't want to do, and so on. So we're always in this constant state of inner conflict. Thank God again for yoga because it helps calm that conflict. But this is really important. This inner battle is really important in terms of this concept of listening quietly. The ancient sage Patanjali is attributed to compiling the Yoga Sutras, and he is seen in statues and art holding a conch shell. So in this imagery, what it really means is that it's a reminder that the war has begun, because again, that conch shell was blown at the beginning of battle. So this image of Patanjali is saying the war has begun. That metaphorical war from the Bhagavad Gita, that war that we have inside, it has begun. The conch shell has been blown. But the war has always been. It has been your job since gracing this earth, the duty to the self, and I say self with a capital S, to carry out the battle and to discover the stillness within. This card then is a calling for us to do the work that must be done. And I talk about this all the time on Dharma Drops and in conversations in my personal life. This is the self-care that we don't want to do. This is sitting in the shit and the muck and the discomfort of your life to get closer to self. Sure, sometimes to listen quietly means getting quiet, doing things like getting a massage, taking a bubble bath, having a glass of wine or champagne. Those things are fine, but they don't actually help us listen quietly because even though we're doing those things, the inner war, it's still there. So to discover the steadiness and stillness of your spirit, it means we have to peel away the layers of conflict in our lives. So how do we do this? Well, I don't fucking know. Just kidding. Well, I kind of know, but really it's up to you. In order to listen quietly, first we have to get really clear and honest with what instigates noise and imbalance in our lives. It's time to check in. What's happening in your life that's creating a lot of chaos, that's creating a lot of mental chatter, that's creating a lot of conflict? And then it's your job to find the tool or the vehicle that offers opportunities of quiet. And I really want to note here that this concept of listening quietly, it's not something that lasts a lifetime, right? It's not like, oh, I understand the self. I understand stillness. I'm able to listen to the quiet within. For most of us, unless you're sitting somewhere like in the Bodhisattva in a cave, for most of us, these are moments of fleeting quiet, fleeting understanding, fleeting clarity, and fleeting consciousness. So it's okay if for 1 second you're like, got it, and then it's gone. That's the work to be done, right? That's the practice. So getting back to how we can do these things, for me, my yoga practice is key. So far in my life, truly, it's been the only tool that allows me to create the space to focus, to hear beyond life's chaos. But for you, it could be something else. Maybe you're not a yogi. After all, Dharma Drops podcast, it's not just for yogis. It's for yogis and non-yogis alike. Maybe it's meditation, chanting, cooking, running, knitting, breathing, walking, painting, dancing, doing the dishes. I don't know, right? The world is your oyster or your conch shell, depending on how you want to think about it. One of the things that we talked about too in the episode with Anna is that a lot of times these downloads of understanding, this clarity or this connection with consciousness, it happens in moments of mundane activity because we're actually not busy, right? If the point is to move beyond the chaos, then we have to stop the chaos. So for a lot of us, that means this sort of clarity or quietness does arrive in things like easy stuff, taking a shower, doing the dishes, taking out the trash, where we're not distracted. So just some things to think about for you. What really allows you to find a little bit of quietness, even if it's just for a second? And I don't mean quiet like turn off the TV. I'm talking inner quiet. This card is an open invitation to put forth the effort to calm the inner conflict, to fight the inner battle and win, right? Doesn't mean you're going to win every time. Remember, this is fleeting, but I think it's a pretty damn big win if we start to understand. If you can truly listen quietly to the self, you will discover that you are not your thoughts. You are not your past. You're not your dramas. You're not your family's dramas. You're not your job. You are the stillness that we listen quietly to. So will I ever love to chit-chat? Nope, probably not going to happen. Will I continue to cooperatively overlap? Probably. But when I do the work to move beyond my life's noise, when I stick with my yoga practice, when I do the things I know that serves me, honestly, I find I have a little bit less to say and I'm more easily able to listen to others. And so when people get mad at me for cooperatively overlapping a conversation at a taco stand, I can respond differently. I can respond with compassion because when I have listened quietly to the self, what I see in hindsight, what I see what happened in that conversation, his battle with me was actually a war with himself. He wanted to be heard. He wanted what he had to say to be valued. And he felt like I wasn't doing that. So when these things happen, when I do the work, when I am listening quietly, then I can more easily offer those gifts because I see his battle as just a mirror of my own. But that can only be discovered through battling the inner war and reaching victory in the quiet stillness of your own heart and mind. Okay, that's this week's Dharma Mini Drop. This card is from the Inquire Within card deck, which you can actually score in the Dharma Drop Shop. In fact, there's a lot of new cards coming to the Dharma Drop Shop soon, so be sure to check them out. So you can head over to dharmadropspodcast.com and check out the cards there. Also, if you've been enjoying Dharma Drops podcast and you feel that you have received something from it, whether it's a new teaching in your life, a new practice, or just a little bit of time to do something you enjoy and listen to podcasts, then I invite you to head over to Patreon to support Dharma Drops for just $2 a month. You can get early access to these card readings, yoga classes, meditations, exclusive content, promotions, discounts, and more. Doing so will allow Dharma Drops to keep on producing podcasts, and you're helping support a one-woman business for just $2 a month. I mean, it's a pretty good deal, right? Just head over to patreon.com/dharmadrops. That's patreon.com/dharmadrops, DHARMADROPS. patreon.com/dharmadrops. You can get the full card reading on the blog at dharmadropspodcast.com/blog/February 14 card reading. Again, that's dharmadropspodcast.com/blog/February 14 card reading. And guys, I think that's it. So again, the mini episodes come out every Wednesday. The regular episodes come out every other Friday. Sometimes there's bonus episodes, but those are a surprise. Okay, until we see each other again next time, guys, listen quietly.